Welcome. Now we are going to discuss RMA, Return Merchandising Authorization. A product may have some warranty. After some period, the customer may bring back the product saying that I bought this from you only. At that time, the organization people want to check whether they have sold that or not. If RMA is used, then they will be able to check. With RMA, a unique serial number of the product can be recorded. For example, serial number of the refrigerator, hard disk serial number, engine number of the vehicle, etc. Let us assume we have to record the engine number of the bike. Let us see how it can be recorded at the time of purchase. And at the time of sales, the engine number must be selected from the existing engine numbers. And also to view RMA reports, and at the time of service, how to check the engine number. In order to maintain the RMA details, we use this part. So here RMA stands for Return Merchandising Authorization, where the unique serial number of the product can be recorded. So example, it can be engine number or chassis number of any bike can be recorded, or refrigerator serial number, hard disk serial number. A product can be having some warranty. So after few months, when the customer brings back the product saying that we bought this from you only, we must have a serial number to check the product. So for that purpose, RMA is used. In order to use RMA, we have to check this RMA support. Then how many digits of serial number we are going to enter? So let us take 6 digits. So now in a purchase or sales screen, you will find additionally one column called serial number. Let us assume we bought 10 bikes, so 10 different serial numbers are to be entered. So that is 11, 22, 23. Add. Continuously we have to add 10 serial numbers. If we want a continuous numbers, then after entering the number, type comma, then enter the numbers. So how much quantity continuously you want. So automatically up from 35 to 42, all the 8 numbers are included. After entering all the 10, as we have entered the quantity as 10 numbers, after entering the 10 serial numbers, this OK will be activated. So if we have entered only 9 serial numbers at that time, the OK will be disabled. So after entering all the serial numbers only, the OK will be activated. So just click on OK. At the time of purchases, they have to enter the serial number. So in case of sales, they have to select the serial number from the existing numbers by using this search. So which one they are selling now to the customer. Now basing on that, we have a report in inventory, RMA wise stock analysis. So here it will display RMA wise stock details. We are having 9 numbers of bikes with serial number, it will display. In order to, so later on when customer brought back the vehicle saying that we bought this from you only, so in order to check the option, we are using report filter. So here you will find RMA equal to type the number. It will display so whether we have sold that or not. All these options related to RMA only. Prefix voucher number to the serial numbers in inverts. If we check this option, the voucher number will be prefixed to the serial number. If we check this option, input RMA numbers before quantity, the user will be able to input the RMA number before quantity itself. Next, RMA based on alternate quantity. This is for alternate quantity. Next, warehouse wise RMA numbers. So if anyone is required warehouse wise RMA numbers, then we use this. RMA numbers can't be reused even after they are issued. So if we check this option, the same number we can't repeat once again. So RMA numbers are unique across all items. So the same number will not be accepted to some other product also. RMA numbers are always numeric. It will not accept characters in the number. The